One thing that's often asked is, how do I get good with Excel? Well, one thing is play with it. That helps. Think about solutions. Think about different elements of Excel that you can weave together and see if there is something interesting that you come up with. And that's how we got to where we are today. Yesterday, I was sitting around in my apartment and I was thinking about this demo that Carlos Barbosa did on LinkedIn, and he showed a dashboard where a slicer was used to show ascending and descending. Fascinating. I didn't go digging into how that was done, but it stayed on my mind. I started thinking, how can I bring some new things together? And I said, all right, dynamic arrays, form controls, and let's see if I can do an ascending descending trick. Got this data, orders, the warehouse that the order is going to be fulfilled from, and the amount of the order. Hey, the data goes down to here, and let's scroll up here. This data is showing the orders coming out of Corkwood and the totals descending. Let's switch this. Ascending. Now, go over here. Uncheck Corkwood, check Anders Point. Now, check also 18th Street. And then everything. And then sort descending. Look at that. So sweet. Then somebody says,
but Oz, are you gonna show us how to do it?
Yes. Here's our data. Our orders warehouse amount. There it is. First, here are the locations. 18th Street. Now, I want to add the tick boxes. I'm going to go to the developer tab. Insert. The tick boxes. I'm going to put one right here. Okay, and it says check. All right, and I want it next to 18th Street. Good. I've got a right click, format control. What cell do I want to link this to? I want to link it to the one right next to 18th Street. Okay. Now I want to get rid of this check. Right click it, highlight, and then get that checkbox one out of there. Right click, copy, paste, and paste. Put this one right here, and I want to connect this one to E8, right next to Anders Point. Okay, now this one, next to Corkwood. Right click it, format control, E9. Okay, let's see what happens. Click this, it says true. Click this, true, uncheck. Now it says false, check, uncheck. Okay, beautiful. Now, in anticipation of using the filter function, I need a way to filter these when they're checked. XLOOKUP equals XLOOKUP. Double click. Look up what? Anders Point, comma. Look up array right here, and I need to push F4 to lock that down. Comma. Return array here. F4. Enter. And then let's click Anders Point. Okay. Anders Point true. 18th Street false. Corkwood false. Next. Order. Warehouse. Total. Watch. Equals. Filter. Double click there. Now watch. What is the array that I want to filter? I want to filter these three columns. I don't need the fourth one. Comma, include this column where it equals true. Close parentheses. Enter. Now watch, we already got some sexy stuff going on here. Corkwood, look at that, look at that. Uncheck Anders Point, check 18th Street. Now, the ascending and descending parts. Developer tab. Insert. Radio button. Stretch this out. Go here. Sort. Ascending. Right click. Copy. Paste it. Sort. Descending. All right, let's click this. Click over here. All right. Now to connect these to a cell, right click, format control, cell link, let's put it up here at E1. Okay. Now the sort descending radio button is going to be connected there. Watch, right click it, format control, E1, cancel. So now when I click sort ascending, E1 shows a 1. When I sort descending, it shows a 2. I'm going to wrap this in a sort. Sort, open parentheses. And I'm going to go all the way to the end, comma, sort index. I want to sort by the third column, so I'm going to put a 3 here, comma, sort order, ascending or descending. Descending will be a -1. Ascending is a 1. Here we go. I'm going to use an if. Open parentheses. If E1 is greater than 1, then -1. Otherwise, 1. Close the if statement. Now, close this formula. Enter. Look at that. We've got 18th Street and Corkwood sorted descending. Let's sort ascending. Ooh. Isn't that beautiful? But we've got one other thing to deal with. Let's uncheck everything. Now we've got an error. I'm going to go up and go if error. Double click there. Go all the way to the end. Comma. Double quote. Pick something. Close parentheses. Enter. Check that out. Check it out. Check it out. All right. Want to look at Anders Point and sort it descending. Wasn't that amazing? Dynamic arrays, radio buttons, tick boxes, tables, XLOOKUP, everything. It's all here, baby. See you in the next video.